had then the notable prisoner called Barabbas. Therefore they were gathered together. Pilate said unto them, Whom will ye that I release unto you, Barabbas or Jesus, which is called Christ? In these verses, he said in verse 15, we notice that in the beginning of his trial, of his interrogation, we see already there is faulty in his character. Amen?
Amen.
He was the person who is have the authority to decide, but he said he asked the crowd, he asked the leaders in the high priest, whom I will going to release. It is the custom of the governor that every Passover feast they were going to release one prisoner. And that time they have two prisoners, Jesus Christ and Barabbas. You are now the governor, and we're going to, all the power is in you. Why are we going to ask the crowd? Amen?
Amen.
So we see the weakness of the character of the governor. Amen? He feared, but the reason is that he feared man. As a reference, can we go to John chapter 19, verses 12 to 16? We will see why he is like this. John chapter 19, verses 12 to 16.
From then on, Pilate tried to set Jesus free. But the Jewish leader kept shouting, If you let this man go, you are no friend of Caesar. Anyone who claims to be a king opposes Caesar. When Pilate heard this, he brought Jesus out and sat down on the judge's seat at the place known as the Stone of Pavement. It was the day of preparation of the Passover. It was about noon. Here is your king, Pilate said to the Jews.
Amen. Until there, sister. So we know now the reason why he's not firm to his decision. He feared man. The elders in the high priest told him, release Jesus Christ now, and we will report to Caesar that you release him. And so because we know that Caesar is the emperor, he is the king during this time, and we know that he is the one that put Pilate in that post, in that office. And now if he now begin to fear, to be afraid, if they were going to report to Caesar, and then I may lose my title. Amen? That bring him fear. And he become double-minded of his decision. Amen? Let us continue. So that is one. He feared man, and he wanted to keep his position. See, he want to keep his position secure. Let us continue in Matthew 27:18. It says, For he knew that for envy they had delivered him. So he knew already that the elders in the high priest delivered Jesus to him because of envy. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus Christ became a threat to the religious leaders. Amen. If we remember last Sunday that he thrown those vendors in the front of the temple. Amen. So now the high priest Caesar is afraid also that, oh, if this is really a Messiah, if the Son of God, then I will lose also my position. So they become, Jesus Christ become a threat to them. In Pontius Pilate, he knew already that these high priests and elders, the religious leaders, brought to him, they brought Jesus to him. They want Jesus to put into death because of envy. That is the second. Let us continue. In verse 19, when he was set down on the judgment seat, his wife sent unto him, saying, thou nothing to do with that just man? For I have suffered many things this day in a dream because of him. Now he received divine information. God used his wife in a dream to inform the wife that Jesus is just. He done nothing wrong. He's not the accusation is all false. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And the wife sent a word to Pontius Pilate. Don't do anything to that man because last night I have a nightmare concerning him. Yet Pilate reject the divine information. Amen.
Amen.
That given by God to use his wife. He reject. He choose. He is now double now. What I'm going to do? I'm going to release Jesus or what? But the one thing is here is his motive. We will see his motive. Amen.
Amen.
So he didn't listen the divine information that God has given to him. And in my understanding, even us, Pilate is a sinner. He don't believe God. He is a Gentile. He is a Roman. He didn't believe God. But yet God used his wife to inform. So every sinner, anyone, even you are a sinner, even we are sinner, if we commit sin, God will also remind us. It is really God is not love the sinners. And but Pilate rejected the divine information. Amen. So, in Luke 23 verse 4, can we go there? It says here, then said Pilate to the chief priest and the people, I find no fault in this man. Then they were the more fierce, saying, he stirred up the people teaching throughout the Jewry, beginning from Galilee to this place. When Pilate heard of Galilee, he asked, where the man were a Galilean? And as soon as he knew that he belonged unto Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod, who himself also was at Jerusalem in that time. Now, we observe here that Pilate is... He don't want the responsibility. Amen. He want to avoid the responsibility. In his weakness character, he personally he examined and found no fault to Jesus Christ. Yet in order to please the Jews, he acted Jesus Christ was guilty. Amen. He examined it. How many times that he examined, keep asking that, and he found no fault to Jesus Christ, but still he didn't give the right judge to Jesus Christ. He's still not firm of his decision. Amen.
Amen.
In Luke 23 verses 19, verses 13 to 15. In Pilate, he had called together the chief priests and the rulers of the people and said unto them, ye have brought this man unto me as one of the as one that perverted the people, and behold, I am even examining him before you, have found no fault in this man, touching those things whereof ye accused him. Nor yet Herod, for I sent you to him, and lo, nothing worthy of death is done unto him. So he examined it. And he sent to Herod. Herod as well examined Jesus Christ, and he mocked Jesus Christ and sent back to Pilate. Amen. They didn't find anything fault, anything wrong to Jesus Christ that he is worthy of death. Indecision. He's not supposed to be. He is the man with power. He has the power to decide. He is not proper that a judge or a governor will ask the crowd, what am I going to do to this man? I'm no fault. Why he need to ask the crowd and he need to ask the high priest and the elders and the of the Jews. So he give them offered. He offered the Jews a choice between Jesus and Barabbas, hoping to free Jesus. Rejected his offer. To free Jesus, they rejected his offer. The Jew rejected the offer of the governor. He could not make his own decision. He want the crowd will make a decision. He want that the high priest and the elders, even that he know already that they brought Jesus there because of their envy to him. Amen. He sent Jesus to Herod to avoid, as to the way to avoid responsibility of making his own decision. To stand strongly for the truth as to and free Jesus, but Herod refused and sent Jesus back to him. Herod as well want to please himself. He want to please man. He want only Jesus Christ. He is excited to see Jesus Christ because he heard many things that Jesus Christ is doing wonders and miracles. Amen. The same as many Christians today, they will only come to Jesus that I will go to church because I want to see miracles and I want. That is Herod. He want to see the miracles of Jesus Christ. And when you don't see the miracles, and then you will leave the church. That is Herod. He sent away Jesus. He sent back away Jesus to Pilate. When he challenged Jesus to perform miracles now, and Jesus answered nothing. He keep quiet. Amen?
Amen.
That is in Luke 23, verse 5 and 7. He said, and they were in the, then said Pilate to the chief priest and the people, I find no fault to this man. And they were the more fear, saying, he stirred up the people teaching throughout the jury. Also, this is what, this time that he sent Jesus Christ to Herod. Amen?
Amen.
In decision, he's a... He offered to scourge and set Jesus free, even though he as the governor in charge, not need their approval, but seeking to please them to reject this also. This is the motive why he keep asking the crowd, why he keep asking the high priest, why he keep giving them choice. It's not only once. The Bible says that third times that he will ask the crowd and the high priest and the Jew, he keep asking them, whom are you going to release? Am I going to release Barabbas or I am going to release Jesus? While Barabbas is a murderer, Jesus, he didn't find fault to Jesus Christ. Why he need to ask the crowd? Because of the motive. His motive, that's why the double-minded man, the Bible says, is unstable of all his ways. This is Pontius Pilate. So, in his state, he offered scourge. Let us read in Luke 23, verse 16-23. I will therefore chastise him and release him. For of necessity, he must release one unto them at the feast. And he cried out all at once, saying, away with this man and release unto us Barabbas. So he said, I will going to chastise him and release him. So still talking to the people, what he will going to do. Suppose Jesus is not worthy of that punishment. He didn't found fault to Jesus Christ. But he said, I will only scourge him, beat him, and then release him. And then the crowd still continue to raise up their voice that away from that man and release Barabbas for us. Amen. So we understand here that Jesus now is an exchange, a sinner and a just man. They were going to release, they asking the just the sinner to release in the just. And the one that is just will be crucified, will be put to death. And the Bible could know no sin, for us to be a righteous, for us to be the righteousness of God. Amen.
Amen.
He is a replacement. He became a he took away the punishment of Barabbas. Barabbas is a murderer, and maybe he is waiting his death penalty around that time. But during the Passover feast, he was released. He was set free when Jesus, they condemned Jesus and put to death. Amen.
Amen.
In his state of indecision, he asked the important question, which person must answer? What I shall do then with Jesus, who is called Christ? They all said to him, let him be crucified. Amen.
Amen.
It is the rejection, total rejection to Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Total rejection to Jesus Christ. They know, they see that many of the crowd witnessed how Jesus Christ performed miracles, healed the sick, and still they choose, they agree. The high priest here, and the high priest here, and you know, he's telling the crowd that when the governor asks you, well, whom am I going to release? Tell them, raise up your voice and tell the governor that release Barabbas for us and let Jesus be crucified. Amen?
Amen.
Finally, against all reasoning, the principles of justice, he released Jesus Christ to the Jewish religious leaders to be killed. Took water and washed his hands before the multitude, saying, I am innocent of this blood, I am innocent of the blood of this just person. You see it. Matthew 27:24, let's go there.
Matthew 27:24. When Pilate saw that he was getting nowhere, but that instead an uproar was starting, he took water and washed his hands in front of the crowd. I am innocent of this man's blood, he said. It is your responsibility.
Amen. He washed his hand. He don't want the responsibility. Okay, you do it. You do it, and I'm not responsible of the blood of that man. Amen. He want to. No, we cannot. We are responsible whatever decision that we're going to make. Amen.
Right.
Even the high priest, the crowd manipulated him. You have to put Jesus Christ to death. Otherwise, we will tell this to Caesar. He is the governor. You are the one that have the power to decide. Why? Example of weak character and indecision. Amen?
Amen.
So, leaders, we must have to be firm our decision. We no need to ask somebody now. Let us put in the example the church scenario. Our high priest here is our pastor. Let's say he is the governor. If there is somebody that commit or do something wrong, is he going to ask somebody? Is he going to ask you, what I'm going to do with this man? What I'm going to do with this woman? Amen?
Amen.
He will have the authority is in his hand. He will going to decide it. He has the one the power to pronounce the sentence. Amen. And that's the rule of Pilate in this. But he was so weak. His character is so weak because of selfishness. He loved the world. He wants to please the people. He wants to please the high priest and all the crowd, the Israelites. He wants to please them. He wants to keep his position. He's afraid that Caesar will remove him from his post. That's why he became very weak and not firm of his decision. Amen?
Amen.
And our study today shows that Pilate, being experienced governor, had the opportunity to stand for the truth and set Jesus free. But weakness of character and decision hindered him from doing so. He was a friend of the world, and that made him the enemy of God. That is in James 4:4. Ye adulterers and adulteresses, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is the enemy of God. Amen. Then how many of us will going to say boldly that I will going to choose the truth, I am going to choose Jesus Christ, I will give up this sinfulness, I'm going to give up this selflessness, I'm going to give up everything that is not worthy of God, and I will choose to follow Jesus Christ. Amen. How many of us were going to say that I will give up doing the part-time every Sunday? I will choose to follow Jesus Christ. How many of us will say I will stop doing immorality? How many of us will say I will stop lying? I will stop all the wickedness, all the hypocrisy, and I will choose to follow Jesus Christ. Pilate rejected totally Jesus Christ. The crowd rejected. The one thing that I can say here, that there is no sinner that can judge righteously. Amen?
Amen.
Pilate is a Gentile. He didn't believe God. While this high priest and the elders, they are so religious, they believe God. They know about the prophecies of those prophets. But when Jesus is there, when the Redeemer is there, when the Messiah came, they rejected him. Amen?
Amen.
They are all hypocrites. They are in the church. They said the holy temple. They are there in the holy temple. Yet they are behaving and living in hypocrisy. Amen.
Amen.
They rejected. Total rejection. They chose Barabbas. Barabbas is worthy of death. Jesus Christ take the punishment without any complaint. Hallelujah. That is our lesson today, that we are responsible. Whatever the decision that we're going to make, we are responsible of it. Amen?
Amen.
Let me read here. Herod wanted to do right, and at the same time, he wanted to please the world or the multitude. In the process, he compromised his conviction and made himself the enemy of God. In Acts 4:27, that says, God counted Pontius Pilate among those who gathered against Jesus Christ. So we notice here that the danger of indecision concerning Jesus Christ. Do not allow friends or sinful relationship to determine your decision concerning Jesus Christ. God holds you personally responsible for the decision you make, no matter who motivated you. You are responsible. Pilate, he was stand. He think he is not responsible of Jesus' crucifixion. Yet the Bible says that his name is there. He gathered together to crucify Jesus. Amen. He is among them. So we cannot wash hand. We cannot say, okay, you go. Go to pastor and report to pastor and don't involve me. Amen? You're washing your hands. It's happening. It's really happening. This is the scenario in the church. So we thank God for the lesson today. Amen?
Amen.
And I pray that we will reject every sinfulness and choose Jesus Christ today in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
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 So you are open now to ask questions. Yes? Yes, Brother Kaka?
Praise God.
My
question is, we all know that leaders have been elected by the people to serve them and to represent them. From our lesson today, the trial of Jesus Christ, we can see here that this leader, Pontius Pilate, tried all he could to save Christ. But all the people, except him and his wife, is on the other side. They all still crucified him. My question is, would it not have been better that God have mercy on this leader? Because it seems he's helpless. The people he's representing, he's serving, all said, because in here in 22, in Matthew 27, 22, he said that they all said, that means all of them, the people that he's leading, they all said crucified him. He tried other means to save Christ, but they all said, then he heed to their request. Would it not have been better? Because he's helping, these the people he's representing, the people he's serving, that God have mercy on him and punish the rest of the people, because it came to an extent that they said, let the blood of this man be on us and our children.
So, my question is,
would it not have been better that God have mercy on this leader, Pontius Pilate, and punish the rest of the people? Why now is it that the blame is much on the leader alone?
The leader, you know, brother, the leader is already made their decision. During the trial last Sunday, our teacher teach us already. They had made their decision already that they will put Jesus unto death. They hired the false witnesses to witness against Jesus. If we remember that during the Passover feast, Jesus go to the temple and drop all those vendors and money changers in that temple. And that's why, the reason why the priest and the high priest and the elders that's the reason why they talk Jesus Christ and examine Jesus Christ. Why you're doing this? If we study the Bible, they are asking Jesus Christ, where did you get the power that you are doing this? They made already the decision that Jesus will be put to death. And not all the crowd are saying that he must be crucified. There are, even in the elders, Nicodemus and the Joseph of Arimathea, they also speak that Jesus is preaching, is nothing wrong about his preaching. But because the high priest is the one that has the power to decide. Amen?
But my question,
yes?
What I want to know is, from his, like, you are the leader, you have the people, you have elders, you have your members of your cabinet. When a case comes to you, and you need to inquire from your cabinet, and all the people are in the other side of the case, you are the only one on the opposite side, and you give them many options, do the right thing, and they all say this is what we want, and you have to obey the voice of the people because you are the leader, you are there to represent them, right? Why is it that God is punishing this leader as the soul?
You know, brother, this leader, yeah. they are not born again, they are not born again, they are sinners, they are all hypocrites.
Amen.
Answer.
Yes. Number one, as a leader, it is good for we leaders to hear the people that you are leading. You understand? And you should not allow the people you are leading to put you into sin. Amen.
Amen.
The governor rightly judged, said yes, he has seen no sin, no fault on this man. But the people that you are leading, they are all sinners. Amen. They are not born again people. Amen. And I said, yes.
You understand? Only the leader is righteous.
No,
even the leader during that time, brother, they are all hypocrites. They are all we see Pilate here that he want to please the people. He don't want to lose his position. All of them. That's the reason why Jesus Christ came now.
Okay, sorry. The problem is that